Good afternoon, Senator. From Albay po, neighbor ng Ligaw.
Ligaw.
From Kidobatan. Ang question ko po ganito, paano ho ba ninyo dinidisseminate ang mga laws na ginagawa nyo? Kasi po yung nangyari sa cybercrime prevention law, nag-react matagal, napirmahan na sa kanag-react yung mga tao. In fact, kami ho, mga Facebook, social network user din, and internet user, hindi namin alam kung anong nandun sa law. And alam niya naman natin hubaga na ignorance of the law excuses no one. So we could be accused of a crime na hindi naman namin naintindihan kung bakit. Napapansin ko kasi, yung mga laws natin, hindi masyadong nadi-disseminate. Hindi masyadong alam ng mga tao. I'll give you an example. Like, yung Solid Waste Management Act, RA 9003, I think everybody or most of us would agree na hindi lahat ng tao alam yung nakalagay dun sa act, kasi hanggang ngayon hindi ma-implement yun at the local level. Marami pang LGUs ang hindi sumusunod, pero kung titingnan mo ang punishment ng LGU na hindi sumusunod dun sa law na yun ay very strong, di po ba? So ano po ba yung measures na pwedeng magawa ninyo as a legislator, and knowing all of this na people, actually even in the grassroots, do not know what the law is or what is found na mga provisions dun sa law? Thank you po.
Thank you, ma'am. I think what happened here is actually a function of the social awareness of the Filipino citizens, the Filipino people. Most of us have withdrawn from wanting to participate in governance, in politics, because we just want to entertain ourselves. We just want to focus our lives just in front of the computer or watching telenovelas. And we cannot penetrate. We cannot expect all the information to be brought in front of us. And that's our problem as legislators. We went through the normal process. During committee hearings, we call on the different sectors, the different stakeholders, because we want to make sure that all this, the possible sectors will benefit from the law that we will craft, and that no sector will be trampled upon. So that's the normal process. And after that, you have it will be published on major dailies, the contents of the law. But who reads newspapers nowadays? And for those reading newspapers, once you see all these publications by government entities, you'll just turn the page quickly. So that's what's happening. It's not entirely the fault of your legislature, and at the same time, it's not entirely the fault of the public, because that's how life is right now. You have to do things, or people tend to busy themselves with texting, mauling, Facebooking, watching telenovelas, instead of being active in governance of our country. So what else can we do? We have posted it online in our website. And in fact, like what I said, it was this particular bill or amendment, individual amendment, was inserted last January. And we didn't hear anything from anybody. So the whole country lost by default in this particular episode. And it's sad, but we will try everything to make sure that we will be able to rectify those oversights. But if you have any suggestions, how can we penetrate into the world of today's Filipino citizen? I'm at a loss, actually. And in line with what happened to, or an episode between Senator Enrile and I, a month ago, you'd be surprised that there is a significant, at least half of our half of our electorate or the public in general are clueless about that particular episode, despite the fact that it was all over the news for a week. So it just shows you how detached our people have become. So it's a challenge, and we'll find ways to enter into the world of our citizens. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, so with that, Dr. Angelo Ramos, we'd like to thank our Honorable Senator Antonio Trillanes, and for our token of appreciation, Senator, please accept our token of appreciation for spending time with us this afternoon.